I'll be showing you guys how to make these high waist shorts. I had originally bought this navy fabric to make a skirt, but there were too many requests for high waist shorts, so I decided to make those instead. These shorts are really, really flexible. You can decide how wide you want the pant leg to be, how tall you want it to go on your waist, any of that. You need 1.5 meters of fabric and two buttons. I chose these buttons, which have the holes in them, so they lie really flat on the shorts. Check it out. You can choose the kind that has the loop in the back. Those ones will stick out a little bit more, so you just need to decide what kind of look you're going for. It's a smooth waistband all the way around. In the front, I've got these darts to kind of add a little bit of structure and shape. In the back, there's not too much going on, but I did add these creases down here. It's because I wanted these shorts to have a more professional look, so I kind of chose a dress pant fabric and I added some creases to make it look a bit more tailored and fitted. If you choose a more flowery fabric though, it's gonna look a lot more like summery and flowy, so whatever you guys like. These pair of shorts are definitely not as easy as some of the other stuff I've been showing you guys, so if you're still a beginner at sewing, I'd recommend taking this one slowly. Again, I didn't do this one with a pattern. I just kind of measured myself and measured how long I'd want the shorts to be and worked it out from there. The thing about when you sew without a pattern is that whenever possible, you need to pin that whole thing together, put it on, and see if it's fitting right. If you tried along the way, you can get rid of any weird bulges or just things that are too long or too short or anything that's not working out right. But if you don't try it on and you try to just finish the whole thing in one go, you might end up with something that looks really nice when you hold it up, but when you try it on, it'll be like, I didn't put all of the details for these shorts in this video because then it would end up being like 10 minutes long. I have a lot of the measurements and the technical kind of stuff in the link below, so go ahead and click there if you want to make these shorts. In other news, it's been about a year since I've been doing this YouTube thing. I'm really thankful for you guys sticking with me this whole time, being patient with me as I try to figure stuff out and figure out what you guys like to see. Thank you guys for also teaching me stuff and sharing stuff with me, because I feel like I've learned so much more through this and I've really gotten better at sewing through this too. Part of this channel being about a year old now is that I wanted to change up the beginning and the end and kind of how the feel of it goes. I know we're all people who like to get used to things, so I'm really sorry if I like alarmed you or freaked you out or made you angry. If you really, really hate it, just let me know, and if you like it, you can let me know too. I hope you guys get a chance to try out making these shorts. Feel free to subscribe if you guys want to see any more of my tutorials. This is With Wendy, and I will see you all next week. Bye!
Here's the pieces that you're gonna need, and if you want any more details, just check out the link below. Once they're all drawn, you just cut them out. Here's how all the pieces look when you're done cutting them out. Unfold all three band pieces and iron them down wrong sides together. Switch one of the front pieces with one of the back pieces and keep them right sides together. Then you sew them together along the inner leg. Take those two pieces and put them on top of each other, right sides together, and sew along the inner U. To sew the pockets to the front of the shorts, pin them exactly as displayed and sew along the straight line to attach the pocket to the fabric. Once that's done, flip the pocket pieces and lay the band and the pockets aligned on top of each other. To sew the band and the pocket to the shorts, go down from the top, go around the pocket, and then go down all the way to the leg. Check to make sure that so far your pockets are looking like this. Fold both of the waistband pieces inside out against what you had ironed and sew them down along the two sides. Dart the front of the shorts as needed so that it matches the waistband. To make these darts, fold the fabric outwards about a centimeter or so and pin it down. Make sure your darts on the left side are in the opposite direction of the right side. To secure the dart, pinch the fabric and pull out the pin, then fold over the fabric and re-pin it right there. We're going to sew about 1 centimeter away to secure this fold. Starting at the top, go about 1 inch in and you're good. Here's how a finished dart looks. Sew the waistband to the shorts, but make sure those darts are pinned so that the fold faces the inside. The next step is to hem the two sides of the back piece. Pin up the shorts and put them on, and then hide the back piece behind the front piece until you're happy with the cuff width. Go ahead and hem the whole bottom. We're now going to sew the front to the back along the sides. Start at the bottom and sew along the sideband, leaning towards the front piece. Stop when you're about at the top of the pocket. Put the shorts on again and measure where you would like the buttonhole to go. Make sure it's the right width and at the right spot. Make a rectangle using a tight zigzag stitch and then cut down the middle to separate it for a buttonhole. After that, you sew the buttons and you're done. One final touch that you can do to make your shorts look a little bit more professional is to pin them along the front and back so that they're perfectly flat, and then you just iron them down to create some creases.